guys, what's good? It's your girl, Bree, and welcome to my fridge. So, in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to make bakery-style blueberry and lemon muffins. So, I'm not a baker, and you don't have to be one either, but these are gonna be so tasty. We're gonna make a streusel topping and a lemon and honey glaze, so you're in for a treat.
To make these muffins, I will be using the muffin method. I like using this method because it produces a cake-like texture. You'll have a super moist and tender crumb. Not to mention, they also help prevent you from over-mixing your batter. And it's super quick, super easy, and you don't even need any fancy equipment.
Okay, so let's begin making our streusel topping. So, I have about a third cup of all-purpose flour, about 1 tablespoon of dark brown sugar, about 3 tablespoons of white granulated sugar. I have about 1/2 teaspoon of allspice, 1 teaspoon of nutmeg, and 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, followed with 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt. In this little saucer, we have 1/4 cup of cubed butter. So all we're gonna do is combine our dry ingredients. I did sift them just to make sure the sugar, you know, wasn't too clumped together.
Now, I don't like my crumble to be crunchy. I like it soft, so it'll like sink into the muffin batter and everything. Kind of like if you were to use like a sweet butter and like you spread it on top of pancakes or something. That's basically how I want my crumble to be on the muffin. But if you want something that's more crisp, just use more flour and less butter. You'll see what I mean towards the end of the video.
Okay, you guys, our streusel topping is done. I put it in the fridge just to make sure the butter doesn't get too soft and melt on us because we do want it to maintain the crumble. So now let's go ahead and make our lemon and honey glaze. Okay, so to make the lemon and honey glaze, I have about 1 cup of powdered sugar. Honestly, you can really use as much as you want, really depending on the sweetness and the overall thickness of the glaze. In this bowl at the bottom, I have some honey. I also have some milk, some fresh lemon zest, and fresh lemon juice. And this is melted butter, and I have 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt. So we're gonna combine all this, mix it together, and that's gonna be our lemon glaze for our lemon and blueberry muffins.
I just like to add a little bit at a time first. A teaspoon of salt. Done. Yeah. This is the consistency I like, so I'm gonna keep it just like this. But if you want it thicker or thinner, by any means, use more or less powdered sugar.
Okay, you guys, as you just seen, I did finish our lemon and honey glaze, and I must say I just tasted it. Spot on. So now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get started with the fun part, our lemon and blueberry muffins. Okay, so in this bowl right here, I have 1 cup of sifted granulated white sugar. I have 2 cups of all-purpose self-rising flour, 2 tablespoons of milk powder, this is non-fat, and 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt. All right, so I'm gonna give these ingredients a quick mix and I'm gonna sift them one more time. I think it's very important to sift your ingredients. I mean, you don't wanna overmix your muffins. So if you sift them, the flour is a lot lighter and fluffier and easier to mix. You don't have to worry about any clumps. You want everything to be evenly incorporated and you want to get an even rise. So, sift your ingredients. So, and it only takes a second. I mind doing this really does help with the muffins. Okay, so now we're gonna start with our wet ingredients. Like I mentioned earlier, I went ahead and took out my wet ingredients and let them come up to room temperature. It's gonna absorb a lot easier in our dry ingredients and also prevent us from over mixing. You don't wanna over mix your muffins. If you do that, you'll wind up getting something that's a lot tougher, denser, and drier, and it'll go through a process called tunneling, which you'll have like little holes, little tunnels in your muffins, and you don't want that. So bring up your ingredients to room temp. So I have 2 egg yolks, and I'm just gonna give them a nice whisk first. Kinda want them to get a little frothy. I feel like that will help, you know, lighten up the muffin. All right, so I whisked our eggs and they got a little frothy, which is what I wanted. I just feel like this makes the muffin just a little bit lighter doing this. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and we are going to add our vanilla Greek yogurt. So this is about 1/2 cup. Just add that right on in there. Now, if you don't have yogurt, you can use sour cream, you can use buttermilk, you can use whole milk. You can experiment and try using something like ricotta cheese. That'll be good. So, there's a lot. You can use just plain yogurt, you know. I'm using vanilla yogurt because I'm like, well, we want to add flavor to these muffins, so let's use some flavored yogurt. So just mix this until it's nice and evenly combined. All right, that looks good. Then we have here 1/4 cup of whole milk. Just add that right on in there. And lastly, this is 1/2 cup of unsalted melted butter. You can use oil if you want to, if you want a lighter cake. I mean, excuse me, if you want a lighter muffin, something cake-like, using 1/2 cup of neutral flavored oil will be nice. It doesn't have to be neutral flavored, but if you're using something like olive oil, your muffins will taste a little bit like olive oil. So if you don't want that, then use something like a vegetable or a canola, cottonseed, grapeseed oil, you know, just a few suggestions. All right, so I have some blueberries right here. These have been rinsed off. So now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna kinda put these in this bowl here. And some of our dry ingredients that we made earlier, I'm just simply gonna take a couple of spoonfuls and cover the blueberries in that. This is gonna prevent them from just sinking to the bottom. So they'll be evenly dispersed. And then just kinda toss them. Mm-hmm. Give them a nice little toss, and that's what they'll look like. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and we're going to combine our wet and dry ingredients. So, and I switched to a rubber scraper because we want to fold these ingredients in. If you don't want to over mix, so just gently fold your ingredients. Now these are muffins, so they don't need to be, this batter doesn't need to be completely smooth, just enough to moisten the ingredients. Okay, perfect. This is what you want it to look like. I'm telling you, don't overmix it or you'll have tough muffins. Here's a closer look. You see how lumpy it is? Not everything is mixed in. That's exactly what you want. If you go further, you're gonna risk overmixing your batter and like I said, we'll get tough muffins. Now, we wanna go ahead and add our blueberries. So we're gonna add them all in there. Make sure you save some to put on top. That's an option, we don't have to. All right, so these are lemon and blueberry muffins. So I'm gonna add some fresh lemon zest and lemon juice. I'm just rolling these on the cutting board to kind of get the juices going. So, and I'm gonna do about 3 lemons with the zest and probably about a lemon or so of the juice. All the flavors in the zest. So you really want to get that zest. I did rinse off these lemons as well. All right, our zest is in there. Now I'm gonna take my knife and I'm gonna cut this lemon in half. And then I'm just gonna hold it upside down like this. So you really should do this over a strainer because you don't want seeds. So I'm being risky, but that's part of the game. All right. Holding it like that will prevent any seeds from falling. So now that we did that, fold them in. Fold everything together. Yeah. Alright, so now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna fill our muffins. So if you want nice big muffins, fill them up to the top. So, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Just like so. You can weigh these and measure them, but that's not my style. It's not my style. Put them on top. Make them look nice.